So if they are looking into tiger reserves around India, our blog is covered all of the tiger reserves that they are looking for. So we are saving that time instead of them looking at website A, which only talks about Ranthambore, or blog number B that talks only about Gir, or third one that really talks about Kabini. So this is the way we should try and incorporate more number of topics sticking in one single blog. Obviously, the main message, like I said, do not confuse with your message. Stick to one message. The ultimate message is to, inform your readers about the different tiger reserves in India. So this is some great thing that we could learn from Wago. Or you also have your Policy Bazaar. You also have n number of, in fact, Ola and Uber also the same thing, right? Sit at your doorstep. You have just sit to get down to booking. You have the auto available. You have, I think they've come up with bikes as well now. You have the car. You have the Premier. Just type in your destination, and you have n number of options available. So then, same way, when you have blog in one blog, when you have Gir, Tiger, Gir Forest, Ranthambore, and your XYZ. So then what happens? You can give a hyperlink of Gir Forest that would take them to another blog on your website, which is talking in detail about your Gir Forest. And on Ranthambore, give them a hyperlink that talks in detail only about Ranthambore. So in this one blog, what you can do is just give brief descriptions about different tiger reserves around India. That's about your aggregation and your agglomeration. Now, before looking into this, going into the next topic, in between, like I said, I'll be discussing a lot of concepts for you to understand. So keywords, I'm sure we've all heard of keywords, and keywords to you would be different from what other people think keywords would be. So each one have their own perception about what keywords are. But when it comes down to writing, and when it comes down to Google, obviously keywords are the most important part of our writing. So yes, the 99% of the searches on Google are based on keywords. So what are keywords? You open a Google window. What was running through your mind? You sit down and type it out very briefly without, trying to frame your sentence in the right way. It's just very brief. Whatever you type in, you expect results to come for the same. Now, if you are looking for chocolates, what you do is you just type in chocolates, right? So when you type in chocolates, obviously all stuff related to chocolates is going to show up. So this is because of Google Spiders.